Jay Shrek. You know, you start every adventure like you're hoping it's going to be epic. And then you come to find out you're frustrated because the road that you thought you're supposed to be on is not the same name of the road you were supposed to be on. And it's kind of interesting. So when you go through here, you're like, wow, Google Earth doesn't always work, you know? So as I'm going through here, I'm looking around and I'm like, man, this cannot be the road that I'm supposed to be on. You know, when I looked at Google Earth, what I saw, definitely did not see this. But, you know, I guess, well, I'm just going to have to get out and show you and go from there what we're dealing with right now. Okay, and let me go through here. And it's pretty... I mean, we're on the start of maybe what you would think would be an epic adventure, kind of. I don't know why on Google Earth I didn't see this. Man, I'm going through a cemetery, and I don't remember seeing... I saw some structures which I thought were abandoned buildings, but I sure didn't think... I sure didn't think I was... Well, let's get out real quick so you can take a look at what I'm looking at. Man, it's already starting to get warm now. You know, these days, it's pretty incredible. But look what we're looking at. Take a look. You know, I just didn't expect to be going through a graveyard on the journey to where I'm heading to. So maybe this is going to be an epic adventure, because I tell you what, I did not expect... I don't know what I, you know, it looked like industrial buildings. That's all I can say. But man, there's the low road less traveled right there. That's easy for me to say, wasn't it? And man, if that's where I'm supposed to be going, it doesn't look like... I just thought it was going to be something maybe a little more majestic. But you know what? You know, you can't judge a book by its cover. Maybe you can. Let's go on forward and see what the hell we got going on up here. I wasn't expecting this, to be 100% honest with you. Tell you what, you just don't ever know. Ooh, I didn't want that. You just never know what you're going to run into down here. You just never know. Never know what the journey has in store for you. You got to take everything kind of with a grain of salt, because nothing ever works out the way it's supposed to. Man. But you just keep on going. So that's all you can do. And that looks like where I'm supposed to meet. But I dreamed, or I thought, that it was going to be maybe a lot more epic. Does that make sense? You know, I thought it's going to be a lot more, a bigger area. Man, this doesn't make any... This has never made any sense to me. Let's take a look. Let's get on out of the truck and take a look real quick, because, man, look at this. I mean, who in the hell would get out here? Who would come out here and dump this stuff in the middle of nowhere? I mean, what sense does this make? You know, and I'm supposed to be in an area that I'm believed to be pretty spiritual, a very spiritual location. And you know, I can't get over the fact that people would come out here and dump their stuff. It just, you know, it doesn't make any sense to me. You know, I guess some of this stuff isn't supposed to make sense, but man, it just disgusts me when I see places like this. You know, if this is supposed to be this spiritual location, why would it be a trashed? I just don't get this, but maybe I'm not supposed to. Maybe I'm not supposed to figure everything out. But what I can figure out, though, is that it really does make me sad when I see this stuff, you know, whether it be graffiti or even just trash, you know. It's pretty incredible. Man, that I was looking for something to be considered a lot more, I don't know, epic? Is that a good word? Is that a good word? You know, just right here at the base, you know, whether this is the right place or it's not. Man, it's pretty trashed out. just amazing how these locations that, you know, that's old trash right there. Those are old cans. You don't see a trail going up exactly, but from what I could see on Google Earth, there was massive amount of trails up here, which was pretty incredible. So we'll figure a way to work our way up this mound. Lots of blue arrows. So I guess that's the sign to find the blue arrows. You know, I'm huffing and puffing a little bit coming up this hill, but I was drawn to this structure over here. So I'm gonna swing this way, and the graffiti kind of drove me over here. Let me see on these rocks here. Man, this is sad. There are petroglyphs on this. They're really beat up, but there are petroglyphs, so we're in the right location. This kind of looks like an amphitheater setting right into here. Let's get on up this. Let's take this trail. Okay, it's kind of funny. Look right through here. These are really prevalent trails. Now they show up on Google Earth. So definitely man-made trails. There's a wall of some type right there. Another trail. Look at all these trail systems. A bed. Why in the hell would somebody have, why would somebody carried a bed up here? That's crazy. You know, I see this stuff here, you're like, is this really ancient stuff? Or tell you what, got some type of fire. This does. Wow, a lot of trash. This definitely was a site though that's been used for years. This is not a, I mean, even though the somebody else is taking it over, somebody with the blue. But I'm seeing trail systems all over this area, which is really pretty incredible. I mean, and with this lava rock, look at all the rock alignments right through here. I mean, these trails are everywhere. This had to have been used. You know, when you first see it, it doesn't look too majestic, so let's just call it. But once you get out here, look how prominent that trail is right there. But once you get up here, you're like, okay, well, wait a minute. I definitely see why this would have intrigued them. I definitely see why this would have been a really, you know, beautiful, intriguing spot. And these trail systems on Google Earth are all over this. So they look like they run all over this area up here. So what the purpose for all these trails, you know, I'm not sure as far as, because there's so many. They're not used just to get from one place to another. This is some type of ceremonial thing. Because there's way too many trails if they just wanted to get from one side of the mountain to the other. I mean, and they're so prominent. So they had to have meaning and purpose above and beyond just getting where you wanted to go or needed to go. I mean, there's a trail that's going up there to this ridge. It's really pretty fascinating because these are thousands of year old trails that we're traveling right now. And you know, look how close. There's either a, I don't know if that's a human bone or, I'm not sure. Well, you know, I don't question anything up here in any of these areas that it couldn't be human. Because when I do that, I'm in trouble because you're gonna find human bones in a lot of places, a lot of locations. You know, there's a cool rock right there. Look at that. Look at the view. There's the truck down there. But look at these petroglyphs right here. Look how cool they are. Sun. Guess what's shining on them right now? Except the graffiti that got put on them. Look at these walks, there's layered rock structures. Look at these permanent trails. There's some beading. There's some still a lot of trash, a lot of glass. You know how this become, you know, they let this become a party spot, and that's what happens. You know, most of these places, whether it be in Gila Bend, they become party spots for these kids. And once that happens, that's what destroys this stuff. 9 times out of 10, it's kids partying. Wow, it's pretty interesting. Man, it's a beautiful view up here. And these trails just go on forever. So we'll follow some of these trails around and see, you know, where they go. But it's pretty incredible that these trails are here. How interesting is this? You know, they were so prevalent on Google Earth. It was like, what are they doing? And you can really see on Google Earth how they wind. Look how prevalent that trail is right there. Look how cool that is. These had to have some type of ceremonial meaning. But then to have these things trashed, and then what was the purpose of this winding here? There, you know, there had to have been a reason. Well, how neat is this? And they wind all over here. Almost to the different points. Here's a crossroad. So we're at a crossroads right here. How bizarre is this? I'll tell you what, I mean, these trails are just, I've never seen anything like this. You know, and I'm looking down here to try, it looks like they run out. The rocks just, this lava feels so bizarre too, because it's in a field. How crazy is that? That is absolutely crazy. What a beautiful day today. Then there's more rocks that go down there. Another trail that heads down that hill. You know, you think they got to go somewhere, right? You think that all these trails have some type of purpose, and they do have a purpose. There's no doubt in my mind. I just don't know what they are. So as we travel through these trails, it's just incredible to see where they go. Well, what do you guys think about this journey so far today? I'll tell you what, this is beautiful up here. Very quiet, very peaceful. Wow, how incredible is this? How neat is this journey so far today? Kind of running out of trails on this side. Yeah, there's some more rock formations right here. I'm seeing as we go through here. Definitely more rock formations. This is a circle right here. See how the rocks come around? Maybe an area that they would have danced. This is definitely a circle. Look at this trail through here. You can see it's almost like a runway through here. See that stretch right there? Holy smokes, what is that? Oh no, looky there. Look at this man. Holy smoke. Somebody left a quarter. Look, somebody threw it. They had horses up here. Look at this. Look at the structure. This is unreal. Now, I haven't seen anything like this here. Look at this. Hopefully you can see it. I might have to try to get the drone up in the air. Hope you guys can see that man. That is incredible. And then there's that old crappy shirt out there. What is up with that? Now, here is another structure here that was something. What does it say? N-O-T, well, so this is some garbage somebody put here. This is not an ancient, that's a letter, N-O-T something. And then you look at this, well, let's look at this a little stronger and make sure that it's, now see, you can tell this is old. Look how them rocks have been in the ground forever. Look at that great guy right there. That's unreal. And then somebody put trash, put a shirt. It's just crazy. This is incredible. This is old. This is extremely old. I'll see if I can't get something in the air to be able to take a look at it. You know, these piles, it's hard to see what's new and what's that. The man was definitely old. This does not appear to be of the same era. Doesn't mean it's not some type of spiritual thing. Now that's old. And what I'm looking at when I say it's old is you can see when them rocks, you can tell when the rocks have been there, how they're embedded into the soil, and you can see that. That man was incredible. That was absolutely incredible. There's a lot of rock structures through here, you know? And there's a big runway through here. Look at this field up here. This is beautiful. You do get a sense of the spirit world up here. You really do. Let's take a look over here. You see where these areas like right here have been cleared. Maybe a fire was there. Oh wow, look at this over here. It's really predominant. Trail coming up this hill. Look at that, wow. I couldn't see that because of that tree, but there is definitely a prominent trail that goes over here. It's like it splits over here. That beautiful view of the valley. You know, you get up here and you realize that how cool it was what they saw up here. There's where we came up. There's where that bedpost is right here. So it kind of made a full circle. But how cool is this? Look how prominent that trail is. Wow. Well, trails go out to that point, then down that hill. Well, I tell you what, and we ended up right back where we started. Wow, that was, man, that was really a cool, cool area. I didn't expect to see a rock formation like that. And be careful getting down this hill. The trail going down is not as good, but that's okay. But wow, how cool is that? I tell you what, didn't expect to go through a graveyard on the way, and did not expect to see something just right off the road that was that incredible. That what a beautiful, beautiful place. I mean, other than being a lot of trash, but you know, that can be cleaned up and picked up, you know. It's sad, but that's what it is. Oh, that was a bend backwards. Hopefully you saw that. That's what happens. This is a pretty rugged trail coming down the hill, but we'll make way. Well, you know, we made our way back to the truck, and I tell you what a cool little journey. You know, we started off not being able to find where we were going because the road was not marked. And then we found the road, and then found a cemetery that we didn't expect to see. I mean, it didn't look like a cemetery, believe it or not, on Google Earth. I looked up here and I looked around, and you know, I saw this little mountain, not much, you know, not much, but wow, it ended up being really cool. You know, not all journeys have to be death and destruction. A lot of these journeys can be fun, and they don't have to be, you know, pack in 3 miles. They can be short jaunts and really incredible. Very sad about the trash of this spiritual place. Very sad. I mean, I hope somebody cleans it up, because wow, how terrible is this? That you can tell that's a very special place. You know, if you like this content, please subscribe. If you can help us out on these journeys, you can become a Patreon member and become a part of the team. You know, on there is a notification bell, so when you subscribe, hit that notification bell. And what that does is that allows you to know when we put out videos, it will email you. Now, we put out every Monday and Thursday, but we go live every Tuesday. So if you'd like to be a part of it and just hang out with us and chat and get to know us, we got a great group of people. We've got a great group of Patreon people that support this channel. And without you guys, it wouldn't be possible. So I'm going to head on down the road and see what another adventure, you know, holds for us in store. But what a great find today. Jay Shrek Black Flag Expeditions. Look at this view. Wow. Now, let's get the truck. Let's head on down the highway. One of the things that's been just fascinating to me is this thought process. When you think about these geoglyphs and these intaglios, which are designs on the ground that are only visible from the sky, you know, it kind of throws a whole kind of different wrench into whether they're, you know, are some type of ancient aliens. It kind of opens that door. And it also at least opens the door that says that, you know, they had something above, you know, whatever that was, whatever they were worshiping, you know, it does open that door that you can't deny. And it just is amazing because when I think of geoglyphs or intaglios, I think of basically more South America where you get the cool big desert scenes, right? You know, but the reality of it is that here they are in Arizona, which is really pretty cool. We're going to take a left right here. Hopefully that'll get us to the mountain where we want to be. But man, I'm telling you what, I am really stoked. I'm glad you could come along today because this is just the start of the journey to find these things from above. Now, one thing we're going to make sure we do is put your seatbelt back on. And then we're going to run down here and see if we can't catch the right road to go to the base of this mountain and see what other gentlemen have seen from Google Earth. Again, you know, Google Earth being the main thing that we use to be able to spot this kind of stuff. Now, there's a terrible sight right there. Now, who would come out here and just throw trash? That is just, to me, is the craziest thing ever. We're going to head up this road right here and... we're supposed to go to the top of that mountain, and there's supposed to be two or three different things up here that should be really intriguing. And so we're going to get up to the top of this hill and see what we can find. Man, I am so stoked today, you know, because this ancient artwork, this geoglyphs, these designs are just so unbelievably neat to me that they still exist. You know, a little bit of history about this is that, you know, a lot of people drove over this kind of stuff because they didn't realize that this art, and if you want to call it art, even existed. So the cool thing about this is that, you know, the people that found these artworks were mail pilots that were delivering the mail and flying in planes, and they found it from above. And so a lot of people didn't even realize what they were running over, what they weren't running over. So we're going to go up this hill right here, and we're going to have a look at what's up here and see how intriguing this is going to be. You know, we had a little confusion when we were stumbling through the cemetery, and the roads weren't named down here. So what I thought was an easy road to find, we couldn't even find, there was no name on the road. And so we got a hold of John,
and John took a look. And so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna head up this hill right here. We're gonna get up there and we're gonna see what's up here. It looks like this used to be kind of a party spot, which kind of sucks. It's kind of terrible. But we got a lava field we're gonna climb up, and then we're gonna take a look when we get up here and see what we have in store. About 100 degrees today, not terrible, but definitely make sure we got our water. But a short hike considerably to what we normally have to do. But let's see what we got.